All right, the ladies and gentlemen, John Suitepee here with part two of the Way campaign in Dynasty Warriors 8 Xtreme Legends Complete Edition. As I said last time, before I start, I'll be looking over the comments since alt-tabbing out the game is a little more awkward this time. So, a couple of comments from last time. One made actually just relatively about 11 minutes ago as of the time of this recording by Kunuchi, who apparently says that Dong Zhuo didn't actually kill DL Chan's foster father. If anything, it was his foster father called Wang Yun. Apparently, Yang Yun made schemes to kill Dong Zhuo, and that would explain why there was a jeweled sword in the cutscene at the start of the escape from Liyang. And his first plan was to use Cao Cao, and then afterwards, he sent DL Chan to him. I don't really know about that so much. I mean, there's a lot of the actual story that the later Dynasty Warriors games do go into from the Realm of the Three Kingdoms, the Romance of the Three Kingdoms storyline, and this is one thing I didn't know about. Also, I was told about the switch counter by Andy Crimson Rain. I'll have to remember to use the switch counter and switching weapons, something I didn't do last time. Keep in mind, I am used to playing with just one weapon, and as I said, it's things for me to get used to. But I will try and use a bit more advantage of that. And also about the compatibility tab. As the character levels up, I will gain compatibility in certain weapons and stuff. And once I reach the 4th star, I will then unlock the bonuses. And one of them was the whirlwind type, which I think was used by one of the enemy officers in the fight, in the escape from Liyang. And also that's why it was so... why he was doing that in the first place was because I needed to switch the weapon out to... since my bow and club wasn't so good against the first officer. And I should try switching my weapons to see if it changes the advantage type as such. So we will have to see. Also, I've had requests to play Dynasty Warriors 8 Empires and Kessen 2 from Gwant Kensman requested Empire mode, and newest Bork suggested Kessen 2. And also something that I learned was apparently the mission I played last time was apparently one of the hardest opening missions. So thanks for that, you chucked me straight into difficulty. You know, I guess it's one of the infamous difficult levels of Dynasty Warriors 8 Xtreme Legends as such. So with that being said, we're now going to move on to the second part of I'm used to pressing A, but actually I'm supposed to press B to advance. So we're going to carry on with the story of Way. Now, I was pondering last time what difficulty to keep this on, and I've decided I'm going to keep it on normal. And what swayed my opinion on this, at the moment anyway, is for one thing, the first level was ridiculously hard, and it's not really a gauge of perhaps what the normal sort of level was like. And also, every time we play a new map, we're going to be playing as a new character. So, even if we were to power up one character, we would then have to go back and pick a new one. So, we will be starting at level 1 quite a lot of times. So, while we're picking up the skills and the weapon proficiencies and all that, I think for the Way campaign, I will play this on normal. After this, I will consider trying to do the next campaign on hard, or any extra stuff on the hard difficulty. But for this first one, I will be playing on normal. And hopefully that will be work out just fine. Also, I've been told I need to pronounce the E in Yue Jin, because there's another character called Yu Jin. So many characters to get used to. Indeed. Anyway, let's continue the story with the Battle of Hulao Gate. Dong Zhuo's strength far surpassed that of Cao Cao. Despite barely escaping Yue Yang with his life, Cao Cao wasted little time in planning his next move. Cao Cao traded on the name of his old friend Wan Shao, and sent out a call to arms across the land. Now is the time to display our loyalty to the Han. As loyal retainers, we must sway Dong Zhuo. In response, numerous warlords answered Cao Cao's call, and together they formed the allied forces. Loyalty, ambition, honor. Each of the warlords harbored their own thoughts and desires within their hearts. This time, Cao Cao felt something else as well. He would not submit to anybody, gaining the strength he needed to keep moving forward. Cao Cao looked beyond the defeat of Dong Zhuo. He was already thinking of much bigger plans for himself. His royal retainer, Xia Hundun, brought with him two new officers to help the cause. Xia Hundun and now Yue Jin and Ni Dian. These fierce warriors were ready to make their presence felt at Hulao Gate. So, I just have to tab real quick, make sure it brings up. Yep, okay. Oh, no. Sorry, I'm just messing around with Windows. So, as was voted for last time, of the three characters, as I said at the start of each new mission, I will allow you to pick which character I play as. And the people in the comments voted for me to play Xia Hundun, a familiar face. Now, he says he lacks an eye patch. He hasn't yet been hit in the eye with an arrow. So, let's rock. So, as you can... Oh. Here's level 4? How is that? Is that because he participated in the previous fight, or does the whole way up the same level? I'll have to experiment there. Does that mean because he was in the previous fight, he gains the same level ups as the others or something like that? Or is it just a whole way thing that everyone gets this? Does the level thing not really matter? I'm a bit confused. Again, I'm trying to learn all this stuff, so I don't know if it means that he individually has a different level or whether it's a team thing. If anyone could explain in the comments, that'd be great. Alright, so now we can equip some skills since we actually acquired some last time around. So this is where we can learn the ability augmentation. So we see Victory Cry changes the chances the items will appear in battle. What else is the Rage Springs? Add a bonus to refilling your Rage Gauge. That could be useful actually. I'm going to take that. The Rage Meter gives us more power, so that sounds useful. Increases resistance against elemental attacks. Sounds pretty useful. Might have to play some elemental officers. Secret arts. Resistance against range. Oh yes, definitely. Oh, it also shows some conditions for upgrading it. Defeat an enemy officer while your speed is doubled. So it seems each of the skills has a requirement to unlock it, which is interesting. We must have learnt all these last. Maybe these have always been here, it's just that we didn't unlock some of them. Let's see, defense boost. Yeah, defense increase, obviously good. So these will basically replace our items, you know, the old Naman Arm and all that stuff. Let's see, increases your attack range, increases the damage you inflict against enemy officers. Oh, that sounds very good. What else is there? Some source of your health when you are knocked down. I'm actually going to take that over Rage Springs, I think, because that sounds useful. So we're going to have restore health, resistance against elemental defense, and inflict against enemy officers. That sounds good to me. So we also have our weapons. We have here the Cutlass, which is our main weapon, and also the Iron Sword. Why does he have two swords? I'm going to switch that out, actually. Let's see if we can't use something else. Let's try... Oh, we got a new extension blade here, which we got last time. Got quite a few weapons last time, actually. What should we try as an alternative? I'm not really sure. There's so many. Oh, what the heck? Let's do this for fun. Let's have him equip the Bowen Rod. Nah, let's just stick with this for now. Until I learn all the different weapons, I'm going to stick with the... That's just kind of boring. Having two swords, though. Alright. I would like some officer information, actually. How do I use my EX abilities? I'm ashamed I can't really tell how to use them. But, Alright, well, we'll just have to guess what they are or whatever. We'll figure it out. Alright, so... Let's play as Xia Hundun.
My might shall illuminate the path to victory.
Illuminate the path to victory, huh? Oh, okay, or we could just go to officer information. That works. Alright, so let's take a look at that move list. So, we have not yet reached the level capable of triggering Aerial Muzu or Muzu Attack 2. Oh, so we have to unlock those with the character? Okay. So EX1 seems to be normal attack, then press triangle twice, and the other one is use it, but also with just with one. Okay. So, a fierce fiery shockwave with attack 1, and work as your power and some weapon wildly, and blue fang. Okay. Okay, sounds good. Alright. So, we've got some battlefield information here. You can see we're all the allied forces. enemy forces. All these people. Quite a lot of people. Alright, so, I guess we will begin.
I am Yuan Shao, the leader of this coalition. The reprehensible Dong Zhua has thrown the court into chaos.
Zhua? That's my Zhua, huh?
He must be extirpated. My allies, join me in this noble quest.
Yuan Shao looks really different to what I'm used to seeing him as.
The nobility. His name is his strength.
Mm-hmm.
I must break free of this and prove myself to the world.
That settles it. You are the one I must serve. Now I'm sure of it.
Why me, though? Surely there are others more worthy.
Who are these men?
You said you wanted strength. I got us some help. These two look like they'd be useful. The time is ripe. The rest is up to you.
Okay, looks like we're going to transition back into the game again. Oh, we're not done yet with the talking. Say, Shui Gate, what are your names? Pardon me, my lord. I am Yue Jin. Finally doubting my own abilities. I'm Ni Dion. Contrary to what you may have heard about me, I could prove to be quite useful. Zahun Dun? I can attest to his skills. He's a bit odd, but I think he'll keep things interesting. I don't think he'll be the only oddball we'll meet in this game somehow. You send here your recruit later, the guy with the claws? Maybe right. During conservation events, you can freely walk about the camp and speak to people with an icon above their head. If you talk to the person with an icon above their head, or press pause, then you can skip the conversation event and the battle will begin. Ah, this is something I remember seeing in Dynasty Warrior 7. Before you can fight, you can talk to people, and then you can start fighting. So, now we control Zahun Dun, we can oh my god, we can talk to so many people! But we must talk to one. Let's do a talk to a cop, I don't want to go crazy though. Getting rid of Dong Zhua. I have to pronounce that differently now. Dong Zhua won't restore peace to the land. Someone else will simply take his place. I must be prepared for when that time comes. I will be needing you more than ever. Alright, what do you have to say for yourself, rookie? I may be strong, but my intuition is stronger. My hunches are usually right. Here's how I feel about this battle. No, I won't say anything. I don't want you to get too excited. So he likes his intuition, huh? Maybe we'll get a chance to play as him later. Let's see what Yue Jin has to say. I've never had an opportunity like this before. It is an honor to be a part of this. Alright, so it's only one thing per person. That's cool. Private. Oh, we can even talk to the private. Ward 1 Shah is amazing. No one should know how to carry themselves. Yeah, we'll see. What's this guy? Blacksmith? Oh, we can buy and sell weapons. Cool. And we have a gold amount, it seems. So we can actually buy stuff. Huh. Well, this is kind of overwhelming enough as it is. So I'm going to leave this out for now. That's just probably something to consider later, I suppose. I guess you can trade weapons and stuff, get rid of the useless junk, buy the good stuff. For now, I'm just going to keep it simple and just focus on the fighting. Got any paper? If we do, we could draw our swords. Okay, that was bad. Sorry. What on earth? I heard that Dong Zhua keeps a really beautiful woman by his side. I wonder just how pretty she is. Yeah, I get excited just thinking about it. Let's hurry and fight our way to his location. Alright guys, don't get too crazy now. Lu Bu is the one we need to watch out for. He's more frightening than Dong Zhua. If you see him, the best thing to do is to run. Yeah, that's a point. We have to deal with Lu Bu again. Hey, it's Lu Bei. Ah, you must be Cao Cao's officers. He is lucky to have so many gifted officers. You will all make this coalition a strong one. Oh, thanks, Lu Bei. Lord Wu Bei, you saved us. We will repay you for this deed. Oh. I'm sorry these conversation events take a while. I've never had this before. Dong Zhuo has gone too far. He deposed the Emperor only to replace him with his heir. He's constantly abusing his power, doing as he pleases. There's no way the others are going to turn a blind eye. Lord Wu Bei, we'll follow you wherever you go. Thanks, that's really useful. Ah, who's this familiar looking character? Hello, Don Wei. Look at all these officers. My face reaction! What the hell? Jeez, look at that face! I'm sorry, this is hilarious. He actually looks pretty much like I'd expect him to from Dynasty 3. Some of them look really strong. Heh, no point in thinking about them. I'll get things done my way. Good luck. He looks really strong. I'm too scared to go near him. Oh, he's not that scary. He's very defensive, you might say. Listen to this. Lord Cao Cao is particular about who he chooses to join him. He only picks the best. That's why I think he has such high expectations for Master Yue Jin and Master Li Dian. We'll see. This was all Lord Cao Cao's planning. Everyone seems to know it was his doing. Alright, we haven't got too many more people to talk to. Then we'll actually start fighting. What Dong Zhuo did was horrible. Words cannot describe what he has done. Ah, Yu She. Never heard of this guy before, ever. This area is known to have tigers, hence the name Hulao, which means tiger cage. Today there are even more frightening creatures lurking about, like Dong Zhuo's officer, Yu Bu. Indeed a frightening creature, no doubt about that. I hear that Master Li Dian has good intuition. I don't know how much of what he says you can trust, though. So he's a bit of a psychic aspirant, but he's a bit of an oddball as well. Master Li Dian likes to study and is well read. He is sure to please Lord Cao Cao. Ah, I see. An intellectual type, then. Master Yue Jin is very modest, but can also be very bold. Lord Cao Cao is sure to like him. Alright, so... Oh, sorry, I missed that. I thought it was the same dialogue as before. Master Yue Jin is skilled with the bow. I would very much like to see him in action one day. Another bow specialist. How many more people are we going to talk to here? Oh, we've missed Gongsun San. Many people have gathered to defeat Dong Zhuo. They gathered under the name of Wan Shao, but it looks as if there are other key players as well. Yes, there are. Me, for instance, and my master Lord Cao Cao. The guard in the Xishui Gate is Hua Zhuang. He is said to be very strong. Please approach him with caution. Thanks for your advice there. Alright, where's Sun Jian though? Wan Shu. Alright, well that's everyone talked to. I'll probably be doing this each time because I do this in RPG type games. So now, let's get on to the action with Wan Shao, shall we? I am Wan Shao, the leader of this coalition. You are lucky to have me on your side. Our objective is to defeat that scoundrel, Dong Zhuo, and to rescue the Emperor and Yue Yang. In order to do that, we must first clear Hulao Gate. So no mercy to anyone who stands in your way. But we're in Xishi Gate though, aren't we? I expect nothing but the best from you. Now get out there!
We must defeat these traitors and restore
the
Han Empire. All units, advance!
Alright, we're off.
First, we must break through Suchui Gate. We shall advance through the center.
Advance from the center towards... we need to go this way then.
We'll need to wait for our allies before we go.
And Sun Jian is way out ahead already. Alright, so I'm just kind of waiting for the... Yeah. Alright, so let's just test out his moveset here. So triangle, he kicks. Huh. I kind of thought you'd do a bit more than just do that, Zadundun. Alright, so this is his first combo. Shoots him up into the air. And this is his EX attack, apparently. Bam! Oh, that is powerful. Alright, let's check out his second combo here. Ground to ground. And now this is his EX. Whoa, nice. It works and all that. Alright, so this is his third combo. A little swipe. 1, 2, 3, 4. Puts him in the air, I assume. Oh, Shang Fu's been defeated already. Alright, this guy is... Oh, this guy is strong against our attack, so we need to switch weapons. Let's switch out to the other sword. Oh. Ah, this seems to be his weakness or something. So let's use it. Alright. We got the storm rush against us, so that means we are in a step in the right direction. We should easily overwhelm this guy, I feel. What am I doing? Whoa! Oh, that was his attack. Okay. Oh! That's his counter. Nice. Learn skill nullification 4. Fight a weapon, Iron Edge. Oh, we need to. We need to get to Sun Jian quickly, it seems.
You and UAG deal with the enemies in front of the gate. EDN and I will speak to Yuan Shu.
Seems a bit slower than I would expect, really, from Zanhundun. Compared to his brother, Zanhundun seems a little bit slower. Just a little bit. But his AoE is a little more notable. Oh yeah, we're not. I love his EX attacks, though. They're pretty good. Me like. Not too impressed with his regular triangle attack though, just a basic kick. But he takes it with a nine. Well, he's taking a while to beat actually, so maybe normal's the correct. Get out of here, Huzoen.
Your abilities are truly amazing. You are an inspiration.
We've already got Iron Edge. Okay. We're almost to Sun Jian, which is our first target. So that should be good. I want to have a horse, but I don't really feel the need to have it, to be honest. Oh man, okay, hit there. Let's deal with him. Okay, come on, Sun Jian. We need to help him out. Quickly. Man, nice battleground here, by the looks of it. We got a long way to go. Alright. Looks like he's only taking a bit of a pounding here. Something that always threw me off about these bars is that black space. I thought it was like a shield or something, but it's just an absent health. Shaman Rod. Good, now I can use Tunnel Trogs. No one will get the beverage to half stone. No doubt. Oh, let's check out his aerial attack. Yeah, okay. Not bad, not bad. Oh yeah, Muzu time. Let's see what his Muzu is. Pretty good. Not bad. Marishen. I guess if I had to come up with new characters. Oh shit, I should have. Ooh, that was my chance to use a switch attack. Alright, let's switch the weapon. There we go. Now he's a bit weaker to this other weapon. With no EX proficiency in this, so this will just be a normal string of attacks with the Iron Sword. Ooh, that's got a nice aerial attack though. Oh wow, knocks him straight in the air. Oh yeah, Storm Rush! Which he completely blocked. Which the. There we go. Excellent. I think we got that. I guess we get multiples of each weapon then? So it's not like all unique weapons, it's like you can get multiple copies of it. Establish Sichuan Shu in establishing a supply line. Alright, let's do that then. Go, go, go! So, Sun Jian's good. I'm a bit worried about those officers approaching from the north, though. They're quite close to our base, but morale's at half. That appears to be what the meter is above the map. That is very detailed. And there's Zhu Rong. Ooh, he was using his counter then. Yeah, definitely. Alright. Coalition forces, morale increased. Uh-oh. Hua Zhuang has appeared in front of Sichui Gate. Alright. Morale's going down. Nice, Dong Wei has taken him out.
The provisions have finally made it. Now.
Oh boy, he's in flames like Wu Bu was. Guess that means he's a powerful officer. He has a big sword, this guy. You know, maybe this time we can play as him. Oh, hang on. I need to switch my weapon. There we go. Oh, wow. He is, oh, I see. That means it's normal. So it's best for me to use my EX weapon. He is blocking like crazy. Oh, we broke his guard. Let's take advantage. Get him. Oh, the forward attack was just a little too slow there. Let's take advantage of it. Oh, shit. He's countering, I think. Which ourselves. Come on, who is on? Oh, is he just blocking? I can't tell if he's countering or trying to block.
Your time is up.
Get out of here.
Another victim has fallen before.
Nice, level up. And twin axes get. Excellent. Alright. So Zanahundun still seems like an easy character to play as he always used to be. He was a good beginner choice in the earlier Dynasty Warriors games. Dying 1 seems a lot more easier though. Just spam that arrow attack all the way. Although that being said, we'll have to test him out on a battle when we don't have the Okay, looks like these captains are just going nowhere. So let's try out that horse thing. So we hold down the L2 button. And we're on! Nice. We don't have to do anything. And we can jump. Whee! Oh, where's that giant stomp attack, though, that I could use? Alright, let's have that, don't we? Okay, switch weapon. Now he's a bit weaker. Bam! So we have to use our other weapon. It'd be kind of interesting, really, to see. Maybe there's a strategy where you can sort of use different weapons as your alternative. I wonder if he can figure out what... Oh, wow, he actually just ignored... Oh, has he switched his weapon again? Huh. Alright, so it seems they switched their weapons too, to try and counter you. It's like an ongoing thing where, like, is he going to switch his weapon again?
You sure know how to fight.
Well, thanks, I do.
Another victim has fallen before me.
Okay, let's keep going. Come on, horsey! Oh, we can upgrade this horse at some point. I'm going to make it. Of course we will. We're going to get with her at some point. Alright, so... Now we have to push forward. We have to ignore all these mobile unit captains. They seem to just give... They seem to be just an excuse to give out supplies and stuff. Health's decent. Should be alright. Anyway, we've broken Xishui Gate. Now we move on towards Dongjua. It's taking a bit of a pounding here.
I am eternally grateful.
At least now we can see what the horse combat's like. 300 enemies already. And we can pick up on horses as well. That's pretty cool. Although it's not a new thing. I think you can do that in 4 to some extent. Or was it 5? Actually, I think it was... Oh god, what are these arrows? Whoa, okay. There's arrows falling from the sky. Where are these arrows coming from? I don't think we want to be hanging around here, guys. They appear to have an archer set up. Need to break for the gatekeeper. Use our cool new EX moves. Wham him.
Now is the time to show the land the glory of my new family. Prepare to march on Hulao
Gate. Take that. I will teach you more how to use flaming death. And he's on. Rage mode activated. Alright. Are they still having struggles over there? Alright. We don't want to really use Muzu one. I would recommend to use the Muzu at the end of the rage mode, but there's no one around. They're still hanging around here. Maybe we should go and deal with the guy doing all the attacks instead of just hanging around like idiots, getting mauled to death. Might be an idea. Come on, horsey. Come on. I believe that's the guy doing it up there. That is.
None of you better try to escape.
Oh, never mind.
If you do, I'll hunt you down personally.
Cao Xiong has sealed off Dong Zhuo's base. And so many environmental conditions. Rain of constant arrows.
Now is the time to attack.
Really? Uh-oh, they're about to ambush him. Yes, you do, Wanshu. Get to it.
Another victim has fallen.
And an upgrade to Victory Cry. Nice. Alright, come on, let's go up those stairs. Put an end to these accursed arrows.
I've gone and gotten myself into a trap.
Why are they not moving? Oh, is that because they're stunned? Oh, we need to do the counter. Come on. Come on, dude. No, come on. Use your attack. Oh, he's not doing it. I'll just try anyway. Oh, I was going to wait for him to attack me so I could do the switch counter, but no dice. Oh, it's coming from those towers. Damn. Yes.
Another victim has fallen before me.
Excellent. Get out of my face. Alright. Get the armor. 30 seconds. Ooh, some health. Yes. Oh, we have two Muzu bars now. Excellent. We can use multiple Muzu attacks. In the end, we'll be able to use up to three when we've powered up our character enough. Alright, so... Maybe we should go and help Wanshu. Maybe real quick.
I was in danger. I am sorry for burdening you.
Okay, never mind. He appears to have fled, so we can carry on forward now. I wasn't going to help Wanshu, but he's okay. Looks like the commander. I assume that's why
the Lord has ordered me to stop you. Come and face my wrath.
Oh, here's Zhang Liao again. The Honorable Zhang Liao. He's also quite a tricky customer by the looks of it. I knew last time we pwned him very quickly. And this time he's surrounded by everyone. I don't think you have much of a chance, dude. I don't rate your chances very highly. Well, I'm not going to help with you, Gongsun Sam.
Your time is up.
Oh, I've caught him. Just barely, though. Need to switch weapon. Ah, now he's vulnerable. Come fight me, Zhang Liao.
I shall withdraw.
Oh, I missed.
I entrust you.
Let's finish him off. Oh, he's been defeated, Gongsun San, but we've taken out Zhang Liao, so.
Hulao Gate is formidable indeed. You need some siege weapons in order to break it down.
Ah, we do need. Fucking ballista! Stop these ballista, I'm not having them up. Nope. Oh no, not these again! I thought I'd seen the last of these last time. We need to kill them immediately. At least this time I have a chance of getting near them. At least this time I can actually damage them. Good. Screw you, Ballista. I hate you so much. One, you sound pretty awesome.
I was looking for an opportunity to test my new tactics. I would have never gotten this far if I didn't have a few tricks up my sleeve.
Dong Zhuo ambush units have appeared south of Hulao Gate. Dong Zhuo was still off the Ram's entry point.
Close the gates.
They certainly have.
Soon I will create my world of paradise.
Uh-oh.
Crush these vile pests. What a waste of my time. You're not even worth spoiling my blade.
Oh shit, Wu Bu's here again. Uh-oh, Wu Bu's arrived. That's bad.
You are doing an excellent job.
Oh boy. Well, going up there seemed to be a waste of time. Looks like we were supposed to go this way instead. Oh well, no problem. Man, this looks really different to the Hulao Gate I'm used to. It seems a lot more like Dynasty Warriors 4's gate. Yeah, whatever. I have to be careful about aiming at Earthstrike. It seems to be like a target can go whoosh turn it around me. That's pretty cool. Alright, so now we must deal with... Oh, we Wu Bu again. Will we be able to actually land a blow on him this time? I mean, to be fair, we didn't really try last time. We kind of just ignored him. Can we afford to ignore him this time, though, is the question. Oh, there's Gao Shun. Oh, he just kicked him. Oh, wow, that kick actually takes him... Oh. I swear that kick actually knocked him back a fair bit there. Oh. Makes his guard anyway. Oh, he's using a heavier weapon. Alright, we switch out. What's it used to doing that against enemy officers? We switch. Oh wow, we actually cheered my victory. Awesome. That's kind of a nice touch. We defeat a friendly, an enemy near some friendlies. Well, I'm talking over the dialogue here a little bit. It's a fast, definitely fast paced. You know, here I am used to text scrolls that take 10 seconds and the dialogue is skimming by. Age-old tactics, huh? Okay, oh dear, need to switch out again. Ow! Stupid arrows. Got him. Brilliant combo. Alright, Wang Yun's weak to my main weapon, which is good. Oh, I've only just now noticed the weapon symbol next to the officer's enemy officer's name. Fucking ballistic, man. The thing is, I can't get up there, so we have to deal with. Jesus, oh, let's get away from them. They can only. Oh, come on! What is the range of these things? Seriously. Damn. Oh, we have quite a few. Really? Oh. Uh-oh. Oh, business has just picked up, peeps. Soldiers flying into the air. You can only mean it's Wu Bu time. Again.
You again. You won't escape this time. Die, insect! Look out!
Nice defense, Don Wee, eh?
I'll keep him busy!
Just kicks him in the crotch. It's like two bulls colliding in the ring.
He stands fast before even Lu Bu. A brave warrior, indeed.
Oh, are we really gonna fight Wu Bu now?
Let's leave this to him. We head for Loyang.
Ah! Where's the wall, Wu Bu? No! Oh, boy.
I have no interest in fighting worthless peons. Stay out of my way if you wish to live.
Stop chasing me! God damn it! I would lead it to Don Wei, but he keeps following me! Jesus, Wu Bu, please! This is so annoying. Why does Wu Bu hate me so much? Alright, we need to... Okay. Go, 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 go! Please tell me that gets rid of Wu Bu, please! Wu Bu is very persistently trying to change. Ah, good. Wu Bu has finally left us alone.
You have come here by yourself? There's nothing quite as sad as a lonely.
Or as desperately brave as one. Yo Chun, no longer our friend. Uh-oh, Wu Bu's mad. And now he's gonna get a little more mad. Oh. Oh dear. Oh boy. Woo Woo is pissed. No one defeats DL Chan in front of Woo Boo. It makes Lil Boo mad. Alright, is Woo Boo trying to chase us? I think he is. I think we're gonna have to try and wrap this up quickly. You sound a bit like Xanadu 1's voice actor. Oh, this is bad. Now Woo Boo has a personal vendetta against us. This could get ugly, folks. We're gonna have to evade Woo Boo, and we're gonna have to try and perceive. Oh, he's already here! Oh boy. I'm going to run! Run away! Run away in a direction that's not horizontal. Must... He set the city ablaze? Jesus, Don Joel, you are desperate, man. Okay, has Wibu stopped following us now? Or is he... Oh, he's still mad! He is still very, very angry. Goes into just pretty good, by the way, I have to say. Oh, man. How are we going to get past Woo Boo? We're going to have to bait him. The tactic I used at the escape from Woo Yang. There's no way I am fighting Woo Boo. I don't want to risk getting killed in like 3 seconds at this point. A challenge for later, maybe, but not for now. I can't even use the true Muzu strategy because you can't charge your Muzu up in this version. So the plan is bait him out far enough and then go for the goal. Okay, go, 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 go. Yes, he's vulnerable, but that doesn't mean we can take him anyway. Right. Hopefully, maybe Woo Boo will be a little less enraged after all that running. Nice, holding a flag. That's nice. Oh no, don't tell me Woo Boo is still following me. Oh my god, he's still following us. Still. Whoa! What the hell is with that health loss? Holy shit! My health just went way fucking down. What happened there? I enter the base and I get burned to death. How am I supposed to get past that exactly? We're dying just going 5 feet into the base, man. I think. Oh, now I'm not. Oh, it must be the horse that triggered it then. Okay. That's fine. Right, we have to get... Okay, that's kind of weird. Huh, I guess it's a way to discourage the horse at least. Don't want to burn to death? But dang, he set this place on fire. Now, he does this in Dynasty Warriors 4 too, so I am used to this event. We don't have much time for this because... Okay, it's not the area, it's going near these flamey objects. Oh, come on, Woo Boo is still chasing us. God damn it. Going near these fiery objects is what kills us. Okay, so we have to be very careful. How are these people still here? The smoke would surely be suffocating the shit out of these people. I need some help.
Forget I said anything.
Think I'm in love with what? DL Chan? Won't be the first time, Ladyon. That who once said as much last time. So, we're going to have to basically bomb rush this mission before Woo Boo catches up to us, or else we are in big trouble. Oh shit, Woo Boo is already here. Well, if Woo Boo doesn't want to go away, maybe we'll try and defeat him after all. Wow, he took no real damage there at all. Right, Woo Boo wants to fight. Not even remotely damaging him. Oh, hang on. We are now. We are taking a chunk out of him.
Unfortunately for you, I no longer fear your strength. This reign of tyranny.
This Oh god, and him as well. I don't think we can handle both at the same time. The rage does actually take a bit off Wu Bu, but not a lot. And it is Wu Bu. We need to get rid of him again. We can isolate him. You need to help me out. Stop actually pissing him off. I'm being chased by a maniac, people. I don't know. Alright, I have to get rid of Wu Bu and then go into Dong Zhuo real quick.
Your abilities are truly amazing. You are an inspiration to us all.
Alright. I will get rid of them if Wu Bu would just disappear for 5 seconds. Can someone please get in his way so I can, like, not?
Sorry for burdening you.
Oh, this is so infuriating. Why did the AI go straight for me? I'm not really happy about this. It's a bit annoying when the AI just forgets everything and charges for you. I mean, maybe in this case it's because Wu Bu, you killed DL Chan. I might understand that, but this happened last time as well. Wu Bu just ignored everyone. Maybe that's just Wu Bu though. Perhaps he just ignores everyone and tries to kill the player. Well, either way, we have to get rid of him. Alright, Wu Bu. I'm gonna drag you so far out of the field, you ain't gonna even be able to see the your fault that time I killed Dong Zhuo. Dong Zhuo actually goes back to base. That's good. Okay. So we bait Wu Bu. We bait him. And almost time. Okay, go! Right. Now we have to hope that we can gain enough time to kill Dong Zhuo very, very quickly. I will try and risk getting the horse through. I mean, maybe if it's just a burning area, then... it's probably the horse thing. Alright, we need to go. Imagine if someone could hold him up for 3 seconds. But he doesn't seem to care about anyone else. Okay. Off the horse and go. Okay. Move it! Looks like a speed dash or something at this point. Would be useful. Fire looks kind of cool, by the way. I'm genuinely impressed with the graphics in this game so far. It's pretty decent. The thing, this is like a... all running on the PC with no problems. Alright, Wu Bu is still trying to catch up to us, but he hasn't... Oh, that's nice. He's not automatically zipping ahead too much. That's pretty cool. There's a bit of... There isn't some rubber banding effect going on where... like in racing games where the enemy cars can catch up ridiculously quick. Who's saying Wu Bu has to actually go for the maze? Alright, you have to die in record time, buddy. Now, this is very similar to what happens in Dynasty Warriors... really, where sometimes if you want to kill Dong Zhuo, Wu Bu's right behind you, so you have to eliminate him fast. Actually, no, I'm thinking of Dynasty Warriors 6. I have played, like, a little bit of Dynasty Warriors 6. Oh, is he counterattacking? Or is that oh, that's a switch. Alright, Wu Bu's almost upon us. Need to break him quick. Come on, quick. He's almost through the maze. Get him. Gotcha.
No one wants a throne you've been sitting on.
Yo, that bird!
Hey, stand your ground! Curse it! I wanted to finish him off myself!
Who are you?
Whoever he is, he saved us back there. My thanks. Will you tell us your name?
I've got no grand name to impress the likes of you. I just know that man is an evil tyrant, and that he brings only pain and grief. So I decided that I wanted to be a part of any battle against him.
Huh. So you just joined in without telling anyone. That's pretty odd.
Indeed. He could prove a very valuable man.
could indeed, Cao Cao. He could indeed. Alright, so we're going to have to skip this because obviously I do want to, save that. The following stages are now able to play in free mode. Eliminate Dong Zhua. Alright, cool. Ah, so we unlocked the stage there. Okay. So, that was, the Battle of Hulao Gate. Pretty much had everything you expect from a Battle of Hulao Gate. It had Wu Bu. It had, DL Chan. It had Dong Zhuo Zhua, sorry. To get used to pounds of that. Raising a City. Holy crap, 51 minutes this took. About 10 of those was a conversation mode. Oh well. I'll get used to that, I suppose. So yeah, pretty fun overall. I definitely think this definitely reinforces my emotion that normal is the place to be for now. I mean, granted, the only real challenge was that fiery spot, but we took enough damage and enemy weapons don't seem to die in seconds, so I think we stick with normal from now anyway. So what do you all think? And it looks like next time we will be at the Battle of Yan Province. As the final land of Yan Province in the Fifth, welcome the Yellow Turban Rebels into your forces. Huh. Interesting. So we go from not quite eliminating Dong Zhua to Yellow Turbans? Okay, that's kind of interesting because the Yellow Turbans are supposed to be before the Dong Zhua stuff. So this could be really cool. And it looks like the three choices for this one, well, we might have a Don Wei, the guy we just recruited from the previous battle, Yue Jin, and Li Dian. Let me know which of these three you want me to play as in the comments below, and I will catch you all next time for the Battle of Yan Province. Maybe I'll finally get a chance to play as one of the two new characters. Or maybe you'll pick Don Wei and we'll see how he plays. Anyway, thanks for watching, catch you all next time.